And I think you recall that I told you that I did not expect Gbagbo to survive politically this battle.
Correct.
Because it was an uphill battle. And then, of course, things happened the way I anticipated then. Second thing, the recent development has shown that the points I was talking about during my interviews were right. I said that Alassane Dramane Ouattara is the one who created the rebellion in 2002. And then he was the godfather of the rebellion.
Thank you.
And then with the recent development, we've seen that his forces have launched a military offensive against the National Army. The second point is the neo-colonial dimension many people did not want to talk about. France is the former colonial master of Ivory Coast. And France has done everything it could to break Laurent Gbagbo. And in 2004, France killed 69 Ivorians and 1,200 people were wounded. And they wanted to overthrow Gbagbo. They did not succeed. But this time, and according to the report of Voice of America, we know that they gave a comparative advantage to Alassane Ouattara's forces to dislodge Gbagbo.
Do you agree that, France, it is true, was the colonial power in as far as Ivory Coast is concerned, but that is also a member, not only a member, but a permanent member of the UN Security Council?
Yes, of course. You know, that's why the whole situation is a biased situation.
But what about the UN Security Council resolution 1975?
That says what? That they can go and bomb civilians and military bases?
Protect civilians.
Yes, protect civilians. But this is the point. On April 4th, when they went and bombed the military bases in which there were civilians, the children and houses and wives of soldiers, and they bombed the national TV, and they bombed the presidential palace in which there were civilians. So I think that's what kind of logic is that. So, and then as the Scott said it, as he said it, they repeatedly bombed many places in the country, and they have killed civilians, and we're looking for the death toll.
What about some of the civilians, in fact, who have been complaining that they were killed by soldiers supporting Laurent Gbagbo?
That's the difference between me and people who support Alassane Dramane Ouattara and many people who support Laurent Gbagbo is that I acknowledge that Gbagbo's forces have committed some human rights violations. And I've said that already. And there were innocent people were killed, but there were also people in arms, who had arms who supported Alassane Dramane Ouattara, who were in a demonstration on December 16. And there were protesters who were unarmed, but there were also people who had heavy weapons in the street. So I have mourned the loss of people who died, be from Gbagbo's side or Alassane Dramane Ouattara's side. But the point is that on April 4th, when France and the UN went to bomb military bases and many places in the country, they were not protecting civilians. They wanted, as Scott said in the report, to give a comparative advantage to Alassane Ouattara's rebels or forces, to win over Gbagbo Laurent. That's the reality.